You know already that the scalar product is continuous, so I can pull the limit of this one, limit of the buff two side, the buff side. Those you have this one, it convert to you V. You have V A U, which will be equal to this one. And this one you convert to F like this. F U. You have this one. Then you have A V, which is the star V like this, minus F V U is equal to zero. Mm-hmm. Then we that V minus F is the orthogonal of this one, the orthogonal of the domain of A, which is necessarily equal to E here, because dA is dense in E, this one, which is equal to not E, but it's equal to zero. Mm-hmm. Because this one is the density, because dA is equal to E. Then the orthogonal which is close is the same also. When you put the orthogonal here, it's the same as the positive orthogonal, because this one is closed. It's equal to each orthogonal. This is equal to zero. Then if one is equal to zero, let me have this one is equal to zero. Let me have this condition. This one is equal to zero. This one is equal to zero. Then AB minus F is equal to zero. Is this one equal to zero? Let's not this one is equal to zero, and you have your condition. That means that the graph of A star is also is closed. Okay, thanks. Now I'll give you the relation between the graph of A and the graph of E star. The relationship will have the graph of A and the graph of E star. What the relation can put in these two A graph of A of the graph of E star? Then you can prove that if you consider a map like this, you can put from E like this. Of E star into E star. This one, you consider this map from VF. For VF, you can have something like that minus FV like this. This image, this one. Then suppose that the image of the graph of the adjoint of this one is exactly the orthogonal of the graph of this one. But you have the relation they get in this one. It's very simple. That's the relationship between the graph of A and the graph of A star. This one is very simple to prove. I'll give you a sketch of the proof of this one. This one is, let's just take some element here. You got proof that this element is contained in also this one. And you say that you put it like this, U, V, V, U, like this, let V. F is an element of the graph of E star. This one. The graph of E star. This one. Not this is the graph of E, this one, this one. An element of also, first of all, element of the dual of this one, the dual of this one. This graph of now if it is the element of the graph like this, that means that F is exactly this one by definition. That means that what for you F for U is equal to V all you in the domain of A. For all you in the domain of A. You can put this. Then, what you can get, you can have here. From this condition, you have this, and that means that you have this, this means that you have F minus F for U must be equal to V A U, like this. That means that you have minus F U plus V A U is it equal to zero. This one, that means that you have F for V and V is the limit of this one. U, A U is equal to zero. When you put the scalar product of this one. And then you have, that means that you have this, what do I put the, I don't know where I don't know where I put it, but my cleaner here. So, okay, yeah, I get it. Yeah, okay. This one, okay. So you have this. From here you have this solution, because this one is equal to zero. This is the polar. If they pull up like this, that means that you have this one, the scalar, this one is equal to zero. I think that the scalar product can be, can you put the scalar product like U, U, V, or U, this one, or U, V, like this. There are many, many notations of the scalar product. This one, like this one, is equal to zero. That means that minus F, V, this one is an element of the graph of A, because this one is the graph of A, because U, A, U is an element of the graph of A. And this one, well, the scalar plot is equal to zero, then this one is the orthogonal of this one. Or this one is just the image of this, and then this one, the minus F, V, is the image of V, VF, okay, put it just now here. The image of VF. That's okay. Okay, yesterday we are somewhere here. Okay, let's remind you what you did the last time. And we are going to have some relation between the graph of A and the graph of the adjoint of A. What kind of relation you can get? Relationship we can get with between this the graph of A and the graph of adjoint of A. Just we consider first of all a map from here, from the dual of F by the dual of E. That is this inside the for all V is here is V. For all V you have this one minus F for V something like that. And we are going to prove that the I for of the graph of the adjoint of A is exactly the orthogonal of the graph of A. So then we are going to get to prove it. So now suppose that we take the limit of the graph of the adjoint of A here. Yeah, that is the element of here. First of all, this one is the limit of F for the dual of F by the dual of E. So where if this one is contained in the graph of the adjoint of A, that means that your F might be the image of B by this operator. And this one, that means that for all U in the domain of A, you have this relation. This one. And for all U, you have this kind of relationship. Then if you have A, the adjoint of A, B like this, that means that this one exactly this one. So you have this one equal to this. Then you have this one equal to this, equal to zero. This one. Then that means that the scalar product of this vector, this one, and then this vector is equal to 0. This element here is the limit of the graph of A. Then this is the limit of your space. So when the scalar plot is equal to 0, for any limit of the graph of A, that means that this one is the orthogonal of the graph of A. Now this one is the orthogonal, is in the orthogonal of the graph of A. You know already that this one is not exactly the image of VF, where VF is the limit of this scalar. So we prove that this one is equivalent to this, this equivalent to this. You can put it like this. Then you, if you are here, you are also go back to have that this one is the limit of this one. Then you have inequality. The I of D A star is equal to the graph of A, the orthogonal of the graph of A. You want to prove yesterday. Then we are going to do study other property of this kind of definition. First, I'll give you some exercise. It's just an application of what you have there. Just an application. This can try to do it. Exercise that is. This exercise, you have to prove that this kind of relationship, prove that one, you have to prove that the kernel of A and by this one is exactly G, the intersect of G of A. Where here you suppose that the G exactly equal to, we put that G is equal to the graph of A, and L is equal to E by the singleton 0. Then you have this, suppose this one is auto G is this one is exactly the intersection of G of A and L. Secondly, we can also prove that you have E, the product of E with the image of A is exactly the sum of G. But they do it also. And very simple. A third exercise test question, you have to prove that the singleton 0 by the kernel of the adjoint of A is exactly the orthogonal of J intersection with the orthogonal of A, F. And the fourth question, prove that the image of the rank of the adjoint of A is exactly before the product of this one, if the adjoint, the dual of A is exactly this one intersection before the orthogonal of A. Okay, try to prove in this fourth question, knowing your mind that G is a G of A and L is the product of E by the same to 0. Then you have this question. If you prove it, you can get some corollaries of this, which is very, very directly from the proof from this question, you can easily have this proof, this corollary also. Corollary of this one. Let's think that you have, you suppose that A, let A be an operator like this, D of A of E into F, which is a linear operator, an unbounded linear operator. And with densely obtained, doctrine defined, and densely defined. There are this kind of thing. Then you have this relation also can prove it is very simple too. And you have one, You have what the image of A is close. This one is equivalent to the image of the dual, the adjunct of A is also close. If you are in this condition, F3, you are also tempo is also proven that AF of the image of A is exactly the kernel of the adjunct of the adjunct for this one and to the orthogonal of this space. And fourth question, you can also prove easily. You can prove that the image of the adjunct of A is exactly the orthogonal of the kernel of A. From here, from which fourth question, you can prove easily this one. So try to understand the prove it also. Exercise. If you have this, you can easily have this kind of property also. And it is very simple to prove. It is using just the definition of the operators, the kernel of A, the kernel of the adjunct of A, and so on. That exactly knowing that G is G of A, and L is also the product of E by the secret to zero. Okay, simple to it. Okay. Now we are going to prove something which is very, very important. So this story. This vector which is very, very useful too. We are in the same condition. A is an operator like this. It's just a linear operator, unbounded linear operator and densely defined. And you have all this condition. You have all these conditions, and I put it here. You have this all condition here. All these conditions which is here. Then from here, you can get you can prove this one is here. You can prove that the following conditions are equivalent. Properties are equivalent. First, you end up that A is surjective. Two, you have also proved that this one is equivalent to the fact that there is a constant C. Except that you have this relation, the norm of V is less than C, the norm of the adjunct of this one of V, the norm for this one. Where V, for all V, element of the domain of the adjunct of A. And third relation to have the norm of the adjunct of this one is exactly equal to zero. That means that this one is adjective and very simple, and also and the image of this one is closed. This one is closed. A is surjective and there is a constant C such as this solution, and therefore this one is the kernel of that is equal to zero. That means that the adjunct of A is injective, and also can prove also that this one the image of A, the adjunct of A is closed, is also closed. The fact that this one is injective is very, very trivial, because if this one A of V is equal to zero, this one is equal to zero, then V is equal to zero. That's very simple. This one is very simple, very obvious, very trivial. Just you are going just to put this one. Don't then you are going to prove that A implies two. 2 implies 3, and after you put that 3 implies 1 to prove that the three conditions are equivalent. Are equivalent. I'm going to prove it. So